friends, welcome to GALLANT IAS HEPGEC program for daily revision. Here we are going to revise both UPSC previous and model questions. So let's move on to the first question from history. Which one of the following observations is not true about the Quit India movement of 1942? Actually, the Quit India movement, which is also known as August Revolution, was launched after the failure of Cripps' mission of April 1942. And accordingly, the Quit India movement and its demand was the immediate end of British rule. The immediate end of British rule in India. So, the civil disobedience movement was also launched along the lines of Quit India movement, which was led by Mahatma Gandhi, and the government, the British government, was not in a position to negotiate, and they arrested all the prominent leaders. Eventually, this movement was in the hands of the younger generations and the militant groups. So, the Quit India movement finally turned out to be a violent movement. So, here the first option is asking it was a non-violent movement. So, if you know, Quit India movement was not a peaceful movement or demonstration and it was violent, then you could easily know that statement A or option A is not correct. So, you will get the answer. Anyway, read the three other options. It was led by Mahatma Gandhi. Of course, Mahatma Gandhi was there. It was a spontaneous movement. Yes, since the leaders were arrested, the younger generation and militant groups took hold of the movement and it spontaneously was changed to a non-violent movement. So, the fourth statement, it did not attract the labor class in general. In general, it did not attract the labor class. And you should know one thing, the non-participants of Quit India movement were All India Muslim League, the Communist Party of India and the Hindu Mahasabha. All these organizations did not take part in Quit India movement. Though these stood away from Quit India movement, the bottom level individuals of these organizations took part in the movement. So, that's regarding the Quit India movement. Now, let's move on to the second question from economy. In terms of economy, the visit by foreign nationals to witness Commonwealth Games in India amounted to export, import, production, consumption. So, here it's a basic concept, means when foreigners are visiting our country, they are being paid for the services that we offer to them. So, when we are receiving payments from them, we are receiving receipts, and this amounts to exports. So, here when we are receiving payments or receipts from them, it is amounting to export. So, here the answer is option A, export. Let's move on to the third question from polity. In the election for Lok Sabha or State Assembly, winning candidate must get at least 50% of the votes polled to be declared elected. Statement 2. According to the provisions laid down in the Constitution of India, in Lok Sabha, the Speaker's post goes to the majority party and the deputy speakers to the opposition. So, here in the first statement, it is saying that in a Lok Sabha election, the winning candidate must at least get half of the votes polled. But actually, the Lok Sabha elections or the state legislative assembly elections are taking place under two main principles. The first is universal adult franchise. And the second is first past the post system. So, here the first statement is saying that candidate must get at least 50% of the votes polled. But actually, this first past the post system is being followed for Lok Sabha and state legislative assembly election, which says that the candidate which is securing the maximum number of votes is being elected. So it's not that he should secure at least 50% of the vote, but it's like he, the candidate who is getting the maximum number of votes, he will be declared elected. So the first statement is wrong. Moving to the second statement, according to the provisions laid down in the Constitution of India, in Lok Sabha, the Speaker's post goes to the majority party and the deputy speakers to the opposition. Actually, here the statement is partly right and partly wrong. Nowhere in Constitution it is mentioned that the Speaker's post is for the majority party and the deputy speakers is for the opposition. It's actually a convention and it is nowhere mentioned in the Constitution. So the second part of the statement is right, but the first part is wrong. So which makes the statement totally a wrong statement. So here, since both the statements are wrong, our answer will be neither one nor two. Moving to the next question from geography. Which one of the following statements is correct? Cirrus clouds are composed of ice crystals. B. Cirrus clouds exhibit a flat base and have the appearance of rising domes. Option C. Cumulus clouds are white and thin and form a delicate patch and give a fibrous and feathery appearance. Option D. Cumulus clouds are classified as high clouds. So here it is being discussed about the types of clouds. Actually, there are three types of clouds: high clouds, middle clouds and lower clouds. High clouds are cirrus clouds, or they can be cirrostratus, or they can be cirrocumulus, and middle clouds can be altostratus, altocumulus. And here lower clouds can be stratus clouds, cumulus clouds, then cumulonimbus clouds, etc. And the higher altitude clouds are composed of ice crystals. And the now let's look the statements. Cirrus clouds are composed of ice crystals. Here the question is asking the correct statement. Actually, cirrus clouds are higher clouds and they are composed of ice crystals. So statement A is, option A is correct. Anyway, let's move on to the other three options. B. Cirrus clouds exhibit a flat base and have the appearance of rising domes. Actually, this is the characteristic of cumulus clouds and not cirrus clouds. Actually, cumulus clouds is having a flat base and they just appear like a dome. Now, the third statement. Cumulus clouds are white and thin and form delicate patches and give a fibrous feathery appearance. This is actually the characteristics of cirrus clouds and not cumulus. Actually, option B and C are being interchanged. So, option C is also not right. Moving to the last option. Cumulus clouds are classified as high clouds. It is cirrus clouds which are high clouds and not cumulus clouds. So, the only option which is right is option A. Cirrus clouds are composed of ice crystals. So, answer is A. Now, let's move on to the next question from environment. In the cities of our country, which among the following atmospheric gases are normally considered in calculating the value of air quality index? So, regarding air quality index, it is actually air quality index is comprising of eight gases or indicators. And you should know if it is difficult for you to remember the eighth of them, at least remember which of them are not there in these eight. And here it is asking which of the atmospheric gases are normally considered in calculating the value of air quality index. So first one, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, methane. So in air quality index, carbon dioxide and methane are not there. So if you just know that these two gases are not there for calculating air quality index, then you could eliminate option A, option C, option D also. So you'll get the answer as 2, 3, 4. That means carbon monoxide, nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide are there. Actually, just know that these 8 gases are PM particulate matter 2.5, PM 10 particulate matter 10, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, ammonia, lead, then ozone, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and carbon monoxide. So these are the 8 gases present for calculating air quality index. So just keep in mind, just know that which all gases are not there, so you could easily eliminate the option. Now let's move on to the last topic, which is a current affair. ATAL ranking of institutions on innovation achievements is an initiative of A. NITI Aayog, B. Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, C. Ministry of Human Resource Development, and D. Ministry of Science and Technology. The various initiatives of government and the concerned ministries are very important. So here, ATAL ranking of institutions on innovation achievements is actually an initiative of Ministry of Human Resource Development. It's actually ranking the higher education institutions, major higher education institutions and universities of India based on indicators of innovation and entrepreneurship development. So here the answer is Ministry of Human Resource Development. So that's all for today. Thank you.